So today we will talk about the Western Ghats. So why we are talking about the Western Ghats? Because you seen that recently there is a high floods in Kerala and as well as the landslide. And once again the Western Ghats got the bite of news. That's why we are talking about the Western Ghats. So we will talk about all the facts related to Western Ghats and why Western Ghats is so important. And there are also the two committees as well. The Gadgil committee as well as the Kasturirangan committee, what are their recommendation, we will also talk about that. So if we talk about the Western Ghats, why we news? So recently the Kerala floods and landslide again bring the focus on Western Ghats, and it is also important because 40% of its area, out of 100%, 40% of Western Ghats area around lies in the Kerala. So this is very important again. So all about the Western Ghats. So this is basically a factual video which consists of all about the Western Ghats and as well as the two committees popularly known for the Western Ghats, Gadgil committee as well as the Kasturirangan committee. So remember that Western Ghats, why Western Ghats is very important? Because known for its high biodiversity, not basically, there are the many types of forest exist here as well as there are the high endemism types of animals, birds, amphibians, reptiles, etc. exist here, and whatever is the globally threatened species actually found in here. And every year we have seen in the news that some new species of fishes as well as animals or birds found in the Western Ghats. That's why it's known for high biodiversity and endemism, and home to hundred of globally threatened areas of plants, animals, birds, amphibians, reptile and fish species. That's why Western Ghats is so important. So if we talk about the total area is around 160,000 km, and if you talk about the total stretch, then 1600 km total area, and there is a difference in the total stretch, total area. So this is all about, and if you talk about the starting, this is very very important, from where the Western Ghats actually originated or started. So it started from the Tapi River. Earlier it was known as the Tapti River, you found in the Google, but now is the Tapi River in the Sonar town in Gujarat, basically at the Gujarat and Maharashtra border. So this is originated from Tapi River. Tapi River very very important because from the Western Ghats started from the Tapi River and ending at the Swamithop near the southern tip of Tamil Nadu. So started from the Tapi River in the Gujarat and ended at the Tamil Nadu. This is very important. And between them there are also four states through which actually this Western Ghats passes. So remember that Western Ghats passes through the Gujarat, as I have told you, started from here, Goa, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So these are the six states which passes through. Very important, these six states. Now next, facts about the Western Ghats. Its elevation is around 1200 meter. And if you talk about, there are many peaks, but the Annamudi is the highest peak in the Western Ghats, which consists of 2695 meter. Remember this name. The Annamudi is the highest peak of Western Ghats. And remember that obviously, as you know, it is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and it is very important. One of the eighth hotspot biological diversity and one of the world 10 hottest hotspot. Means those whoever is the high biodiversity are very susceptible. If there is any damage to this kind of hot spot, then it can lead to damage in the even whole ecosystem. So that's why it is one of the 8th hotspot biological diversity and 10th hottest hotspot. There is a difference between the hotspot biological diversity and hottest hotspot, and both is responded by the UNESCO. Remember that Western Ghats is older than the Himalaya according to the UNESCO. This is one of the another important fact. And if you talk about the 39 areas of Western Ghats, including the National Park, Wildlife Sanctuary, Reserve Forest, were designated as World Heritage Site, which consists of 20 in Kerala, 10 in Karnataka and 5 in Tamil Nadu and 4 in Maharashtra. So there is a 39 areas of Western Ghats is actually declared as World Heritage Site according to UNESCO. This is very very important because in any of the exam, river is very very important one. And Western Ghats, because of the larger area and passes through the six states, obviously there are many rivers which passes through it. So major river which originated in the areas of Western Ghats consists of the Godavari, Kaveri, Krishna and थीमापारी एंड तुंगाभद्रा, दीज फाइव रिवर्स एक्चुअली ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम दी वेस्टर्न घाट. सो लास्ट वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट दी रिवर्स. सो व्हाट आर दी रिवर्स एक्चुअली पासेस और एक्चुअली ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम दी वेस्टर्न घाट. सो नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट दी बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स, नेशनल पार्क एक्सेट्रा, देन दी नीलगिरी बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम दी पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ वेस्टर्न घाट. एंड इन नीलगिरी बायोस्फीयर देयर आर दी मेनी एक्चुअली सेंचुरीज एज वेल एज नेशनल पार्क कंसिस्ट विच कंसिस्ट ऑफ नागरहोल एंड बांदीपुरी इन कर्नाटका एंड दी वायानाड मुकुर्ति इन केरला एंड मुदुमलाई सत्यमंगलम इन तमिलनाडु. सत्यमंगलम इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट कनेक्ट्स द वेस्टर्न घाट्स टू द ईस्टर्न घाट. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नेशनल पार्क. यू शुड रिमेंबर इट कनेक्ट्स द वेस्टर्न घाट्स टू ईस्टर्न घाट एंड एटसेट्रा. सो दिस कंसिस्ट ऑफ द नीलगिरी बायोस्फीयर. सो दीज ऑल गिरी इज दीज ऑल नेशनल पार्क और वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी कंसिस्ट इन द नेशनल पार्क. Another which is important to the Western Ghats is Silent Valley, which is also is in Karnataka. If you talk about the Western Ghats climate or you can say the geography, then the tropical evergreen forest found here, moist deciduous forest, solas are also types of forest found in the Western Ghats. Some another important fact, Western Ghats consist of the 5% of India's land. Means out of 100%, there is a 5% of Western Ghats is India's land. 20% of all species found in the Western Ghats and 80% of hydropower generation from these Western Ghats, which is situated in the Kerala, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, etc. So this is all about Western Ghats. So from this fact, you have seen that what is the importance of the Western Ghats. Obviously, there are these some developmental area like 80% generation. And obviously the high floods, high landslides in Kerala takes place as well as in the Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. And due to these all kind of region as well as there are the poaching, sand mining, quarrying and as well as there is a hydropower generation. These all things makes the Western Ghats very vulnerable. And that's why due to these reasons there are the two important committees formed by the government of India. The first one is known as the Gadgil Committee and another is the Kasturi Rangan Committee. So there are the different recommendations and basically first is the Gadgil Committee and which gives some recommendation which is more radical and environmental friendly and all the state objected to the recommendation of Gadgil Committee. Then to review or look at the Gadgil Committee, there is a Kasturi Rangan Committee appointed by the government, a high level committee, and in 2011. So we will talk about what is the main recommendation of the Gadgil Committee as well as the Kasturi Rangan Committee. Now look at the two committees. So this committee is known as the Working Group Ecological Expert Panel, and that is the first committee is the Gadgil Committee. So what is said that all of the Western Ghats should be declared as eco-sensitive area with only limited development should be allowed. Remember that this is how you know environmental friendly and quite radical in nature. So what it said, all of the Western Ghats, irrespective of the thing, you should declare as a all is the eco-sensitive area. And remember that this eco-sensitive area is declared under the Environment Protection Act of 1986 and declared by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. And what said that the governance system should be from bottom to top, not from the top to bottom. Means the Indian government or government of India should not declare anything, or it should be given the task to the Gram Sabha or at the block level and then district level. This is the good recommendation made by the Gadgil Committee. Another is the constitution of Western Ghats Ecological Authority as a statutory body which will look at the whole matter of Western Ghats, which is also a good recommendation. But this is the very radical recommendation and Kerala is especially objected to this. Even all the state is objected, but Kerala is heavily objected to this recommendation because 40% of area lies of Kerala in the Western Ghats, and there is a sand mining, quarrying, development, hydropower project heavily in the, and development can be stopped through recommendation if this applied. So that's why all the, and to happy all the state, there is another committee formed in 2011 known as the Kasturi Rangan Committee. What it said? It said not all of the area should be declared as the eco-sensitive area, but only 37% of the total area should be declared as ecological sensitive area or eco-sensitive area. There should be a complete ban on mining, quarrying, etc. in eco-sensitive area irrespective of the thing. Highly polluting industries should be strictly banned. Highly polluting industries also known as the red industries. exclusion of the inhabited region and plantation from the purview of ecologically sensitive. This is actually the pro farmer, because there are farmers and inhabited people actually who actually do the farming, and there are these some things which is also excluded from this purview of ecological sensitive area. So this is what the recommendation of Kasturi Rangan committee. But the continued floods, landslide, poaching, hunting, forest fire, etc. This is leading to the heavy damage of Western Ghats, and in future it can lead to further exaggerate the matter. So looking at this matter, actually last year what happened, that the government of India declared around the 50,000 square kilometer something area like that as eco-sensitive area, and although Kerala also objected. So this is what the current status of Western Ghats. So this is all about what things you need to remember in this kind of thing. Basically, why Western Ghats is important and what is the river originated and what is the national park is very, very important. And this is known for its high biodiversity and high endemism in the area, and that's why Western Ghats is very, very important. So thank you guys. Hope you like this video. You should subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching this video.